Hallo, meine lieben Freunde, was geht? Willkommen zurück zu einer neuen Folge von Let's Play Stories Untold. Wir sind im letzten Chapter, The Last Session. Und spielen's. Oh Mann, ich bin gespannt, wie das sein wird. Das letzte Kapitel, das letzte Level. Und gleich kommt nochmal das Intro, ne? Oh nee. Warum überspringe ich das nicht? Warum nehme ich das mit auf? Warum gehe ich nicht ins Level und starte dann die Aufnahme? Naja. Okay. Ah, jetzt. Oh, lol. Laut.
I think that's enough of that for now.
Okay.
You're quite fond of this show, aren't you? Okay, come on. Let's get you down to the observation room. This place must be starting to feel like home to you.
Ach, wir sind im Rollstuhl, wie es aussieht.
I'll get you out of here eventually. Just in here. Okay, are we through in the next room? Just relax and we'll get started in a moment.
Okay.
Right, Mr. Asian, now are you ready?
Okay.
Just hit record on the tape deck in front of you when you're ready. This is subject 12-19-86-23, new session entry. We have myself, Dr. Alexander, leading, and in a room we have our patient, Mr. James Asian. As we know, James has recently recovered from a 2-week coma following his accident. In our last 3 sessions, James's attempts to recollect events of the accident seen him merging his memory with his imagination. These episodes have always ended in panic, and we've had to terminate the session abruptly. Let's try and do this one better, James. So when you're ready, let's bring this back. I know how difficult this must be, but you can do this. James, it's time to remember.
Okay.
Your mind, it's like a conscious black box. Can show you your memories. Look into it. In your most recent episode, you recalled a false memory of a remote weather station. You were isolated from the rest of the world. Locked inside your coma. We interacted with you daily, encouraging you to wake. Your family would do number puzzles with you. Anything really to bring you back. People needed answers, James. Do you remember?
I have another signal here for you, James. It's at 5610 FM. You can't miss it.
Okay.
Ah.
Komm schon. Mach das schneller.
Type in the numbers, James. You gotta see this. This is 20F, 12, 19, 86, 23, 04.
Was nochmal?
Type in the numbers, James. You gotta see this. This is 20F, 12, 19, 86, 23, 04. Type in the numbers, James. You gotta see this. This is 20F, 12, 19, 86, 23,
04. 20F? James.
You gotta see this. This is 20F, 12.
LOL. Mein Spiel hat's... Was? Hä? Das Spiel hat gecrashed. LOL.
86,
23, 19, oh. Alter, Code Word ist was? Reference. Also gar nichts, nee. Schade. Johnny F. Fatal Accident. Accident. Bin ich hier vielleicht doch noch irgendwas? Nee, scheint mir nicht so. Muss es ja hier eigentlich irgendwo stehen, ne? Oh Gott. Kann das nicht lesen, nicht wirklich. Da unten ist irgendwas angekreist. Out of control. Empty whiskey? Ach, Whiskey Bottle, okay. Okay, ich versuch's mal so. 20F minus Fatal Accident. Okay. Ich versuch's mal. Ah, okay, nice. Nice, 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 nice. Okay, dann ist das nächste Empty Whiskey. Und Out of Control. Okay.
Find the signal, James. Listen to the voices. You have to face it, James. Finally.
Not like him at all. I've worked with Officer Hennings for 6 years and not once have we even talked about alcohol. Drunk driving. He was a father, a husband. He was fine. No way he caused this. It's him. This Haitian guy. He's got something to hide.
Okay. Ich hatte nie irgendwelche Besucher? Oh Mann. I did tell you no, let's get through somehow. Another door you never opened. Oh! Muss ich einen Schlüssel finden oder so? Oh, die ist auch offen, die Tür. Oh, Alter, die Maussensitivität ist so krass, ne? Schlüssel!
Add the keys from the table. Way heavy in your hand.
Ja. Okay. Alter, die Maussensitivität.
The waiting area is dark, but you feel a presence.
Okay.
On your neck, standing over you.
Huh?
You feel dread in the pit of your stomach.
Okay, we have a 22-year-old male just brought in from a vehicle collision. He was awake and mobile at the scene, but collapsed on arrival to the emergency ward. The other passengers died in the accident. I'm getting no pulse. Prepare for defib. Amp charge full to 10 and give me 100 joules.
Yeah,
Come on, 100 joules. Charging up full to 10.
Nee, das ist das Falsche, oder?
Come on.
Ja, komm, geh doch ein höher. Danke. Nein, nein, zu weit. Und das auf 10.
Can we get this on the screen, please?
Okay. Alter.
No reaction from first stage. Let's try higher. 200 joules. Keep the amp charge at 10.
Okay, wie es aussieht, hatten wir irgendwie einen Unfall oder so?
Keep the charge at 10. Let's go.
Und jetzt sind wir gerade im OP und werden operiert oder sowas.
Clear.
Oh Gott, ey.
Okay, we have a reaction of some sort here, a weak signal. Let's keep going. Increase again. 360, charge full.
360, ja man, ich mach ein 360. Woo.
Come on, 360, hurry.
Ich hoffe, die Aufnahme laggt nicht. Kommt mir nicht so... Oh, perfekt.
Clear. Well, would you look at that? It seems we have a pulse. Rhythm is stable. We need to run an x-ray right away. Where are we with that x-ray?
Achso.
Let's get it going now, please.
X-Ray ist an. Was soll ich jetzt nochmal machen? Das muss aus. Musst du das an? Nee.
Where are we with that X-Ray? Let's get it going now, please.
Ja, X-Ray ist doch an. Was für X-Ray nochmal? Wie war X-Ray nochmal? Scheiße. Ach, das hier, ne?
Where are we with that X-Ray? Let's get it jetzt. Going now, please.
Okay.
Looks like an intracerebral hemorrhage. We need to drain this now to relieve pressure. Prepare for trepanation. Switch on a drill, please. The drill, please.
It's on. Er ist an.
Can we get this on the screen, please?
Ach, hier. Okay.
Mr. Ishin. You've made excellent progress. You're doing great. We need you to stay calm and try to relax.
Oh, nein.
We're going to do these next steps. We're going to attempt to alleviate some of this discomfort.
It's okay. Not only is tonight New Year's Eve. Okay. But tomorrow you leave on the 6 months trip abroad with friends. Mom, Dad and your sister Jennifer have decided to throw a party to celebrate it all. The house is full. You're in the living room and as usual you don't recognize a soul. Das hat immer geholfen. The room is full of chatty strangers, mostly friends of mom and dad. There's a door to the hall. Open door. I'm sorry, I don't understand. Go to door? Hä? Recognize someone. Hey, warte mal. Look around. Yeah, the room's full of shady strangers, mostly friends of mom. Dad, there's a door to the hall. Go to hall? You push through the crowd into the hallway. The hallway is as welcoming as ever. Only this time, the folks have put a great big banner up across the main wall. Half-finished drinks are abandoned and on almost every horizontal surface. Stairs lead up, also the party is firmly downstairs. Go down. Go down stairs. As much as you'd love to, you promised you'd stay downstairs with the party. So, go upstairs. So, get a drink. You aren't drinking someone else's drink. Get your own. Get your own drink? Hey. Yeah. Same as ever. Stairs, door to the living room, and door to the kitchen. Go to kitchen. Nee, go to... Ach doch. Kitchen. They say all the best parties are in the kitchen. The kitchen is full of people and loud. There are drinks and food on the table, and the party is in full swing. Dad has cooked the hog roast, which sits proudly on the table, although no one is eating it. Eat hog roast. Maybe later. Okay. Look around. Da ist doch dieses andere Room. Ich weiß nicht mehr, wie der geschrieben wird. Utility room, genau. And writing on the wall. Also, Jen is here, signaling you. Go to Jen. You push through, apologizing over and over to get it to Jennifer. You hug, you're going to miss each other. You thank her for the party. She asks if you are enjoying the party. Yes. You tell her it's great, yes? She tells you enjoy it anyway and to loosen up. She asks you to get her a drink. Get Jennifer Jen a drink. You pour Jen a drink and one for yourself. Okay, there's never an awkward silence with Jennifer. She always has a question. She asks if you have everything sorted for the big trip. Yes. You tell her yes. That you have packed everything with plenty of room to... Ich hab's nicht gelesen. Another hug. Your family have really went out their way to make this trip happen for you. It might be what you need to get some perspective and maybe not fuck up so much. She's going to miss you. You're going to miss her. She walks away. Jen has disappeared into the crowd. You're left standing, nodding and smiling at the approving faces. There's so much to do for this move. Can't mess it up. But first, a drink. Get a drink. And down another drink. Anything to move the night along. Go utility room? You open the door and peer in. Okay. You're never allowed in here normally. This is where Dad keeps his fine wines and whiskies. Ceiling to floor racks. A collector, although he does actually drink them too. There is a bottle with a ribbon around it and a card. Reach card. You pick up the whiskey and the card. It's your dad's handwriting. Son, we're so proud of you and everything you've achieved. You've earned this. It's a bottle of 25-year-old double malt. You shouldn't really, but you have to try it. With your whiskey in the hand, you take in the room around about you. There must be thousands of pounds worth of drink in here. You really must thank your dad for the whiskey. Drink whiskey. You take a swig. It's probably the best and strongest you've tasted ever. Just wow. Go to dad. I'm sorry. Okay. Leave. You head back into the kitchen, clutching your new best friends. You stumble out of the utility room and back into the kitchen. That is one strong whiskey. You take another swig and give the thumbs up to Dad across the room. He nods and winks. Go, Dad. Go to Dad. Wink. Look around. Busy and noisy, we'll need to find somewhere quieter. Leave. Go back out of the hallway. A few bumps and lots on the way through you and you make it to the hall. You stop dead in your tracks. It's Jen, covered in blood. What? She's starting straight at you. No one else notices. Scream. Blood is dripping down her face. It's mixing with tears. Scream. Keine Ahnung. Go to Jen? Doc? Hilfe!
I'm sorry, I don't understand.
We tried our best, Mrs. Ashen, but her injuries were too severe.
No, I don't understand. I was just talking to her.
I'm afraid Jennifer passed away before we could get to her in surgery. We did the best we could. I am so sorry.
Where is she? Let me see her.
Please, Mrs. Ashen, take a seat.
I don't want to take a seat. Let me talk to her. Now.
I'll arrange for you to see her. In the meantime, James is in recovery. He's stable for now.
I don't want to see him.
You're standing in the hallway. Something had stopped you in your tracks while searching your mind. Your sister interrupts. She waves her hand in front of you and asks if you can drive her home. You still feel out of sorts. No. Drive! Doors to the kitchen and living room leave from here while stairs take can't take to up. Go upstairs. You'd love to call it a night, but Jen is waiting patiently. Go to Jen. Drive Jen. Do something. Go outside? There's no more until you find those car keys. Ah. Go living room. You're sure your keys are in the living room? The living room has a much more relaxed atmosphere compared to the kitchen. Various guests are sat on the chair having civilized conversation. Yo, civilisierte Konversation. Okay. There's a coffee table in the middle of the room. Your mom is pouring a drink at the drinks cabinet. Look around. Coffee table, drinks cabinet. One of the chairs is overflowing with jackets and coats. Look for keys. You need to look for them. They must be either in the kitchen or in the living room. Look, coffee table. Drinks on coaster like proper civilized people, and you can't see your keys. Look, drink cabinet? What is drink cabinet? Your mom's collection of wines and spirits. Definitely no keys in here. Leave. Empty-handed, you'd head back out into the hall. Yo. You're standing back in the hallway, bottle of whiskey in your hand, but no car keys. Jen points to the living room and sighs as she puts on her coat. Go kitchen? Maybe your keys are in the kitchen. The kitchen is busy, way too much heavy, crammed in here, but I guess this is where the food and drink are at. The guests are like a set of vulture picking at the roast on the kitchen counter. Your dad is looking up the utility room. Look around. It's difficult to move around in here between all the people in the kitchen and the kitchen table. Look, kitchen table. It's difficult to move around in here between all the people. Hey! Mal wieder lief. Yeah, back out of the hallway. Yeah. Bottle of whiskeys, blah blah. Okay. Yeah, we can talk in the car. Go get your keys. Go Upstairs. Okay, hier muss es doch nochmal in der Kitchen sein. Warte mal, kann ich nicht auch hier? Look around. Okay, go kitchen. Go utility room. Your dad stops you. No way, son. I think you have had enough of my hard-earned collection. Okay. Oops. Look around. So. So we go to move here. Ja, genau. Go kitchen table. Look. Kitchen table. So, hä? Get keys. Mann. Talk, Dad. Dad tells you to take a sister home, but to go slow since you've had a few drinks already. Talk, people. Your exchange, please. Was? Okay, not a smile, not a smile. Look around. Jetzt? Hä? Search. Keys. Look. Coat. Ja, sie will ja nur im Dings, ne? Ach, warte, mit meiner Mom kann ich noch talken, ne? Go living room. Talking. Tears immediately start to appear in her eyes. My son of the America, she gives you a hug. Hug, Mom. Look around. Look, chair. Various friends of your mom's and dad's are deep in conversation. Look, jacket. You search through all the jacket and coats until you find yours. Aha! Car keys in the pocket. You grab both. Leap. Okay. Keys in hand, you head back into the wall, into the hall. Jen thanks you for helping her out. She is working in the morning and no one else is in any fit state to drive. You can handle it through, whatever. You know the road. Like the back of your hand, don't you? Yes. No. Leave. You open the front door and walk out into the freezing night. The cold air hits you. You are glad you have your jacket with you. There is a dusting of snow around you as you step down from the porch. The yard extends around the back of the house, and the car sits at the front of the house. Go car. You fumble with the car handle, confused, until Jen tells you to maybe use the key in your hand. Ja, das wäre eine Idee. Use key. Fumbling with the car keys, you eventually get the door open and climb inside. The car is racing. As you fumble around with your seat belt, your sister opens up the car glove box and hands you a note and a key that was inside. She tells you that it's for when you return. Start car. You tried to turn the ignition with sheer willpower, despite holding keys in your hand. Use key. It takes a number of attempts, but you eventually slot the key into the ignition. Hit start, car. You turn the key in the ignition and the car roars to life. Drive, car. The car squeals but stays stationary. Jen suggests releasing the brake, giving you a wide-eyed stare. Us? You very hesitantly release the handbrake. You move the car in gear and pull out the driveway like a first-time driver. You really shouldn't be I am driving very drunk on the road towards the town where your sister stays. James started dozing off as soon as the journey get going. This shouldn't take long. You come to a junction. Is it left or right? You can't remember. Left. Drive left. You don't want to, but you had better ask Jen for directions. Ask Jen. She grunts and throws her arm to the left. Ha! Sag ich doch. Drive left. You turn the car left at the junction and was? Confident that you are on the right road, now you loosen up and put your foot down on the accelerator. You feel powerful as the engine roars and your comment. Jen sits up in her chair and clutches your arm. She asks you to slow down. Slow down. That's not what really happened, so...
You're all over the place, James. Pull over.
Jen is hitting your arm and telling you, crazy sister, strange. There is a set of headlights coming directly at you, but really slow, like slow motion. You try to react, but your body isn't responding. There's nothing you can do to stop this. There's no way to control it.
James, for fuck's sake,
the lights merge
over.
With your car. The outside joins the inside. The whole world around you begins to scream. Oh god, oh god.
It was at this very moment, wasn't it, James? The moment you lost it all. Your sister. Your parents. Yourself. And then you made it worse. Go on. Show us what you did.
You wake up in the car. Your world is upside down. Your seatbelt struggles against gravity, trying to hold you in your seat. An impact into another car has torn a hole in the chassis. Poisonous fumes spilled into your car from the engines. You are in grave danger. You have to get out of here. Go out. Open door. You can't move. Your seatbelt is still in place. Remove seatbelt. You release yourself from the seat. Gravity takes over as you stump on to the roof of the car. Was ist das eigentlich hier mit? Okay. Mann, ich kann nicht schreiben. You squeeze through the wreckage and falling your knees on the ground. Ach man. Every breath brings pain in your chest. To your chest. Your head is throbbing. A blue car has smashed into the passenger side of your car. Your life cannot be ruined by this. You're standing holding your whiskey and your dad's note and flashing
lights are approaching at a distance. Read note. The note always... changing. Now reads, get through this. James, I don't care if you want to or not.
Go through.
Keine Ahnung. Drink whiskey. Come on, James. If you drink this now, you are going to get what's coming to you. Wait. Leave car. Read note. Nochmal. Ja. Flashing lights are approaching at the distance. Go to lights. Look around. A crash site. Smoke balloons from the crash cars to the sky above. Exterior lights flicking and on and off. Ach so, das war doch remove wreckage oder so, ne? Wreckage oder sowas? I'm sorry. Go to car? What car? The other blue car or yours? Go to blue car. The door is jammed. You don't have time to messing around like this, James. Go to your car. There's nothing that can help you in there. You need to fix this before the police arrive. Yeah, remove. Wie wird denn das geschrieben? Wreckage? 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 Oder so? A blue car is smashed into the passenger side, ja. Yeah. Jen. Run away. Wait for police? Turn lights off. Keine Ahnung, Alter. Burn whiskey. Gut. Ah, warte mal.
put whiskey in blue car. With the lights approaching closer, you begin to hear the shrill of their sirens. You simply cannot go to jail for this. You clean the bottle to remove your connection with whiskey. You then very deliberately spill the remainder of the bottle's contents onto the driver, and you toss the incriminating evidence onto his passenger seat. Okay. A circle of flashing lights is around you, illuminating the crash site in the darkness behind them. An army of people all staring. One figure steps out, a silhouette. Talk. Try to talk, but you're not making any sense. Okay. As you approach the man, the pulsating lights around you get dimmer and dimmer.
I know you. I know you're tearing yourself apart over it, but no matter what you keep telling yourself, you have to listen to me. That accident, that poor man, me. You have to remember.
Will ich das?
Your fault.
Oh!
I know what you did. How you left me there to protect yourself. Planting evidence on some poor man. You went headfirst into that officer and you wrecked all of our lives. And then you couldn't even take responsibility.
Ich hab aus dem Spiel geklickt, nein!
You did the right thing for you and no one else. Save yourself. Only it was wrong, wasn't it? Look at you now. Utterly consumed by it. Say it, James.
Oh, nee.
Say it. Tell them. Listen to yourself.
It has to end, James. Do you not understand?
Ich weiß nicht, was ich machen soll.
This episode you're having must come to an end. Make it stop, make it stop. Do you remember?
Ja, ich war's. Keine Ahnung, ich...
Stop the session, Mr. Ishii.
Eh?
Go back to where we started.
Ah.
Put an end to this nightmare. You can do this, James. You can let go.
Hey, haben wir doch angefangen, oder? Was soll ich machen?
He has quite an imagination, the show he's been watching.
Ich hab schon wieder aus dem Spiel geklickt.
This time he described an alien he visited as a government conspiracy sort of lab. It's interesting stuff.
Ich hab da doch eben was aufgesammelt, oder nicht?
But I guess it's just his way of coping. For now, we'll see how we progress.
Mann!
flieg immer aus dem Spiel, weil die Maus sich... Also, es ist so dumm hier zu bewegen, ey. Hä? Ah! Jetzt aber! Wow!
Well, I think we've made progress today, Mr. Ishin. I guess we should tell the police what you've told us. Although I don't suspect they'll take you anywhere. I think you'll be with us for quite some time. Come on, let's get you back to your shows. I'll see you tomorrow.
Admission Achievement. Hey, war's das jetzt wirklich? Also, ich meine, what? Wir hatten also einen Autounfall, weil wir gesoffen haben. Haben dabei unsere Schwester umgebracht und irgendwie... Ja. Okay. Gut. Credits. Ich liebe Credits. Credits sind fast toll. Endlich. Ich glaube, sie sind vorbei. Stories told. Errungenschaft freigeschalten, okay. Wow, dann war's das wirklich. Wow. Also, das war ein geiles Game. Ohne Witz. Das war ein richtig, richtig geiles Game. So wirklich Horror war es jetzt nicht, fand ich. Aber es war geil. Und ich hoffe, euch hat es auch gefallen, Leute. Wir sehen uns bei das nächste Projekt wieder. Haut da rein.